Hi everyone, hope you're doing well from whatever you're watching this channel, depending on your time zone. Now, we are a little bit late, but we have to look into one by one on the issues happening in this country as far as the politics is concerned. Now, one day to Madaraka Day, it was on 31st of April, and before Gachagua landed in Bungoma for Madaraka Day, he was somewhere in Mount Kenya region. He issued a kind of a warning, and it seems to be a prophecy a prophecy that he had seen earlier as far as the politics of Mount Kenya region is concerned. And this is exactly what Gachagua said. It was in Kikuyu dialect. And you know, when people resort to politics in their language, then there is a retreat. It tells you now it is purely local politics, and this is a deputy president. So Gachagua came out clear, and he told the people, "I am not too clever, and neither am I a fool. There is something I know, and I look keenly. Wake up early and look. I see darkness. I see some plotting against us, and our children being used against us." That was a political statement from Rigathi Gachagua.
Muno on the claim. Koyo kaudu joy. Gadarora karora garora mukira tene garora. Gona gatuma. Gona tokebangiru. Nasia nasitu. Ihodero otokayania.
Now, on 1st of May, Ruto responded to Gachagua in his presence in Bungoma County during a national event, that those who are prophesizing darkness and prophesizing evil ahead of us, I pray that priest to pray against those tanks. Because this nation, meaning Kenya, is a blessed nation. That was William Ruto.
Wale wanao tutabiria giza na kututabiria maovu kule mbele, hizo ndimi naomba maaskofu muombe zikome. Because this nation, and I am speaking as the leader of this great nation, this nation is a blessed nation.
Now, we are continuing this final discussion, but just a quick request. For those who are watching and you are not a subscriber, please consider subscribing. To our returning subscribers, I must say thank you so much. And again, to all our viewers, please give this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much, and back to this discussion. Definitely listening to Gachagua resorting to his mother tongue, Kikuyu. Then the response of William Ruto in public, it confirms one thing, that gloves are off. Mambo ya kwenda slowly on each other is over. The gloves are off. It's a bare knock. Very clear. That it is not going to be a hidden story. It is publicly clear that both Ruto and Gachagua are going to exchange bitterly anywhere in public. That when Gachagua will get to his people, he will start telling them now clear what is happening. And Ruto is going to respond to Gachagua directly. He will no longer use his close allies like Oscar Sudi and the team. Mainly he is going to respond to his deputy, and he is already doing so. Sababu anasema kwamba nikiangalia mbele naona giza. Yeye si mwerevu lakini pia si mjinga. But when he look keenly, he see darkness. Where is this darkness? And who is creating the darkness? He see a plot against Mount Kenya. Because he's saying, I see a plot against us. So there is a bad plan against Mount Kenya region, but it is being executed by individuals who we referred to earlier as outsiders. That means William Ruto, the Rift Valley. But he's using their own children, Ndindi Nyoro, Kimani Ichung'wa, Moses Kuria, Anne Waiguru, ameongezeka pale, and others. They are being used by these outsiders to plot against the community. So Gachagua is worrying the community. Therefore, going forward, for those who listen to Gachagua and take him seriously, this one is saying, Ruto is the enemy of Mount Kenya region. Because he's plotting evil against them, using their own sons and daughters. So their enemy is Ruto. Therefore, going forward politically, Gachagua's target is to deal with the enemy of Mount Kenya. And his enemy, number one, is his boss, William Samoei Ruto. So, Gachagua is declaring war against William Ruto. That's clear. There is going to be a political war between Ruto and Gachagua. And Gachagua has made it very clear. Ninaona giza. Huku mbele naona giza. So Ruto learning that he has become an enemy number one of Mount Kenya according to Gachagua. Now he is rebuking Gachagua that he is a seer of, you know, evil. Those who are prophesizing darkness and evil ahead of us. He is now asking the priest in the house to pray against those tongues. So it seems like Ruto is listening very keenly to every step that Gachagua is taking. Anyway, Gachagua is having any conversation, be it in Kikuyu or in English or Swahili. Ruto will listen keenly where he don't understand. We need an interpreter to tell him the truth. So you see, this was in Kikuyu. But he got to read Gachagua's words very clear. And you know, when you want it to sink very clear, put it in your language in a way that people will understand the dialect properly. So Gachagua put it because it was a deep one. It was a serious one. So that people will receive it very clear. And Ruto is not taking it easy. He's now taking the mantle to dismantle Gachagua. But he just started that ombeni. How ambao wanatutabiria maovu na giza. Even if Ruto is going to work with Gachagua, this is a forced marriage. There's no converging interest here. Even if Gachagua will be forced to work with Ruto, kama atamfikia, they resolve their differences. Gachagua will be working with William Ruto, but deep in his mind he's going to know that I am working with an enemy. Nothing is going to change Gachagua's mind from that direction. He knows clear that he is working with an enemy. So tukiendelea mbele kwa sasa zetu, tutaona cheche za kurusiana maneno, tutaona cheche za matusi pia hata zikiibuka, tutaona cheche za tofauti kubwa sana za kisiasa zikichipuka kati ya Mheshimiwa William Ruto na Gachagua. Hawa wawili hawatatembea barabara moja. Na wana saizi ukiangalia, ilikuwa ni kawaida ya Ruto na Mheshimiwa Gachagua kwenda Mount Kenya pamoja. That was the issue. Sorry for that. But as of now, ask yourself a question. Why is it that Gachagua is deeply concentrating in Mount Kenya region? Hapendi kutoka inje kwa saizi. Sana sana tangu Mheshimiwa William Ruto arudi. Ile siku tangia aende Rift Valley, akawapiga lecture, then akarudi nyumbani. He's not getting out. Ruto, in less than 3 days, Gachagua is busy in Mount Kenya. So he knows that he does not hold Mount Kenya region political grip, but he's looking for that, a way that he can resolve the problem and hold the grip of Mount Kenya region politics. That is what the Shaka is looking for. No one is going down on his knees begging forgiveness from Uhuru Kenyatta and the rest, because he know he will need the backing of people like Uhuru Kenyatta and the rest. I don't know if Uhuru is going to forgive him. But the only way for Gachagua to succeed is to get the hand of Uhuru Kenyatta. Otherwise, if not, winning the war against William Ruto is going to be also a nightmare for Gachagua. Frustrations are going to come because tomorrow I want to come back to Kithure Kindiki are now giving warning to Gachagua on social media. So the scared as a police, Hana security, and we go with the drone and the rest. The drama will continue. Soon his budget is going to be sliced. He will have no money to give us handouts. But Ruto is allowing him, as of now, to use his money. Then at the right time, after he's exhausted, he will come in. So gloves are off. We are going to see more fight publicly between Ruto and his deputy.